everybody, and welcome back to Starmade. I'm Dougimus, and we're playing on the StarSquadron server. We're working on our elevator. I've opened up some new spaces and made this space bigger to fit in the logic we're going to need. And unfortunately, we're not going to be using wireless logic for this project. I really wanted to. It would make it all neat and tidy, and you wouldn't have to do any creative hiding of cables. But unfortunately, we're going to have to do some creative hiding of cables because wireless is just too buggy for this to work. So, we're going to start with buttons. So we're going to take two activation blocks, and we're going to put them on each floor, and this is for the purposes of cable hiding. If we put these two here, we can then link down to the left one, and up to the right one, and when you fill in the hull, these wires will be totally hidden. So we'll quickly do this for every floor. And move on to the next step. Okay, we have the lovely problem of not being able to just put cables wherever the hell we want, because we're not going to want them to show up. So, we're going to have to create some pathways to upper floors. So we're going to start by putting an activation module under these lips here. One will be for up, one will be for down, and we got room for more up and more down in these corners here. So, for consistency's sake, making all the floors the same and making it able to be expanded, we're going to put in some of this piping. Now we don't need this one, that one's going to be hell. More piping. Now, since this is the top floor, a lot of this piping is just for show. Nothing's actually going to be going through the piping at all. But we're going to come down here, and we are going to be completely out of activation blocks somehow. Let's go over here into my warehouse, open this up, and put whatever is in my inventory away. Then let's go back to the elevator. Okay, now we got some activation blocks back. And we're going to put these back in these corners again. Now, not all of them are going to be used. Some of them are just going to be placeholders. And we're going to do it on every floor, because we want to be consistent so that everything is expandable. Okay. Let's go up to the top floor. We're going to need a couple of hand signals. Now, I'll explain why we need all the hand signals later. But for right now, one's up, one's down. So, down, up. And we're going to do that on every floor. Down, up, and I think we have to do the first floor still. Yeah. Down, up. Okay, so down, we want to link to one of these left ones to go down. Because we want to keep everything consistent. Left is down. Left side of the room will be our two options for down. So we're going to link to this button down here. And then we're going to take this one to the floor below. And do that. Now, we haven't put any piping in on this floor. So we're going to do this. This now comes down from this end to this floor, and we need it to activate that button. If we link it directly, there's going to be an ugly pipe. We don't want that. So what we're going to do is we're going to use an activation block right here. And finagle it around. So now when pushing down from here, it should make the car go to the middle floor. Yay, the elevator goes to the middle floor. Let's do this up button because it's really, really easy. We're going to link that one. This one right here. That's going to create this lovely pipe wire, and we're going to put this pipe in its place, but you can't see it. Now this just needs to what floor are we on? Okay, we want middle to go up. So we're gonna link this one to this one. And this one's already linked up here, and then we're gonna link this one directly here, because we can. That wire's not in the way. That'll make it go up. Now, we have a down button here. Now, the only option for downs is this one. So we're going to put a button in here to link it across and hide the wire. Link that across there. And then we're going to go down, 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 there. And it's linked, and this isn't in the way, so we're just going to link it right there. This will make it go all the way to the bottom floor. And all the way back to the top floor. And we'll test this down button. Let's go down to the middle floor. Down to the bottom floor. Now we need an up. And up from here is easy because we're just going to go to this one here. Not from there. We're going to go from there to that one there for up. I'm going to go up to there. And then from that one, we're going to go here. So now we've got all our annoying, really, really ugly logic set up, and let's get all the pipes in place now that all these buttons are doing exactly what they're supposed to. That one makes it go up. These two work, and down up here works. So what we're going to do is we're going to go down here and we're going to go set this access. Set this access. And we're going to put in piping. And it'll put in the four pipes in the right spot. And outside, we'll put in some pipes. And here, we'll put in some pipes. In between floors, we'll put in pipes. And the pipes all up here are done. So now we're going to move on to some better logic. You might have noticed that even when this elevator is down on the bottom floor, up here, this floor, I can select the down button and it'll go up to the middle floor. How does that make any sense? Well, it doesn't. So, we're going to take some activation blocks and make sure we're not selecting anything. We're going to put one here, and we're going to do it on every floor. Okay. And then we're going to take the block that the car sits on, which is the one at the level of the lights. And we're going to link it there. So, up to this floor, level of the lights, this one's pointing sideways. and link it there. Level of lights, link it there. Okay, and to show you what it does, we're going to go down, and we're going to fly down, we're going to beat the elevator down there. And when it gets there, that one, this light's going to light up. Alright. So then, that's where these ands come in. And we're just going to pair those like that. And like that. And like that. Now, when I'm on a floor, like I'm on the first floor, if I try and hit down, the car doesn't move. It's not on my floor. I can't control it. Okay. So, now we're going to need to route somehow call buttons. Now, let's get some buttons out. Oops. Let's take off our symmetry planes. Unlink everything. And let's say we want our button there. It matches our up and down buttons being there. So we're going to take that and we're going to connect it down there. And then we're going to not do that. Route it across the room. And route it to our call button. So now when you hit this, it's going to trigger the elevator to come to this floor, which is exactly what we want. We've called the elevator. We want it on this floor. Okay. And we're going to have to do something similar for every other floor. Shouldn't be active. Okay, we'll diagnose that later. That isn't working like it should. If I call the elevator down here. It should light up. But then if I send the elevator away, it shouldn't be lit anymore. Okay, let's test this. Let's take this light out and put this activation module. Now, that'll expose an activation module in the setup if we have to leave it like that, but we'll see. Bring the car back down. This is the way rails used to work. It used to be right behind the rail for it to function. Okay. So,
that doesn't work.
Not only do you have to put it behind there, you have to link it. So, let's unlink this one from there and link the new one we've put in so that it continues to hide the cables. I'm going to go up, turn this one off. Unlink that from there. Put that light back there. I'll take the light out of there, rather. And link that up. Turn it off. Oh, right. R. Elevator down. Oh, that was convoluted, but it works now. So we have a call button, and we have these two. I'm going to leave it at that for today. And next time, we're going to discuss having the elevator not move until you step on it. And that'll take a few other interesting circuits you may not have known about. So, for now, I'm Dougimus, and this is the Star Squadron server. See you next time.